Welcome to another Living With episode featuring the 2018 Nissan GT-R. Today, I'll be putting it through its paces not as a performance car because we know how good this is at all the fast stuff, but as a car that you can live with on a daily basis. So what do you say we get started with the VIP you might recognize?
Wake up from a napper, open up the front door, ain't afraid to show it. Bunny and sunglasses, riding that GTR. Turbo's always full up. Me and my boy Alex, gonna hit the playground.
So to prove how easy the Nissan GTR is to live with, I have borrowed Ethan's godson. This is Luca. You may recognize him from a previous Living With episode. Say hello to everyone, Luca. Say hello.
Hello.
Oh, this is Luca. Shall we go to the park?
Yeah.
Are you excited? All right, let's do this. Do you know the noise that this car makes?
Yeah.
Rah! Rah! Mm. That's the noise of the Nissan GT-R, according to a 10-year-old child. 10 years old?
Yeah.
Yeah? God, kids grow up fast these days. So anyway...
I bought a motorbike.
You bought a motorbike? Is that legal?
I like the noise.
Is it better than this?
Yeah.
Is it?
Even a smandy T-Rex looks like a car T-Rex. I got two T-Rexes.
You've kind of lost me there, I'm afraid. I've lost my train of thought. Do you think that the Nissan GT-R is supercharged or turbocharged?
Turbocharged.
Turbocharged. Yeah, you're right. What are we going to do at the park?
I'm going to go on a little swing as well.
Yeah? Can I join or am I too big? I'm not too big, am I? I'm really short. I think we're pretty much the same height, Luca, you and me. Out of 10, what's your rating of it?
10 out of 10.
10 out of 10?
Yeah.
Wow. So what do you think the top speed is of this car, Luca? 200 miles an hour, you're right. High five. Yeah. See, imperceivable, the gear changes. It's like that, isn't it? It's like butter. Right? Are you looking at me thinking, what an idiot? Is it fair to say that I've turned you into a bit of a petrol head?
Nanny got some more Smarties.
There's no bearing with our conversation. So shall we go to the park?
Yeah.
I think you want to go to the park. That's not how you open the door. Now what?
Oh, wow.
Go on. Faster. Faster!
Keep going. Push me harder.
Have you had fun today?
Yeah.
Did you enjoy the car? Are you hungry?
No.
No, I'm quite hungry though.
Yeah.
Can you just hold on to that for me?
Yeah.
Thank you. Want a bit?
Yeah.
I'm going to go play some golf, okay?
Yeah.
I'll leave you here? Okay. Bye. So the Nissan GT-R is, like it always has been, a really usable, practical supercar. It's spacious enough for two people especially, and then you can fit kind of two smaller people in the back for short journeys. The boot's big enough to fit a whole bunch of golf clubs, plus more. I've got all my stuff in the back as well. When you're pootling around town, as I am now, it's quiet, it's easy to drive. The twin clutch automatic gearbox changes gear really quickly and pretty much without even me noticing. We all know that the GT-R does track stuff extremely well. It's one of the fastest cars that you can buy, but it's also one of the most accessible, one of the most usable, one of the most practical supercars as well. It's a nice thing to drive slowly, as it is an awesome thing to drive fast. There's a day-to-day practical supercar. This one takes a lot of beating. So my time babysitting Luca is done, and I am now off to a place that I've never been to before. But it does have the word driving in it, so I'm quite excited. So I've got a set of golf sticks, and I'm about to go onto the pitch and do some ball driving. Take the stick sock off. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go for this. Good form is important. Bum out, arch your back, hands on the stick. Look where you wanna drive, that way. Watch this. Where'd that go? Getting my eye in, couple of birds there flying past. Put me off.
First time I'm impressing myself here. Work your hips as well, all right? You want to loosen those hips. So this is why a car like a GTR is perfect for something like this. You can drive fast on the way to the golf driving area, and then you can smack some balls. And when your back hurts from all the golfing, you can sit back in the GTR because the seats are actually really nice. There's a lot of lumbar support in those. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is how you golf.
And now let's get some opinions from people about the Nissan GTR, what they think about it, and if they'd buy one.
I know it's a lot of car, supercar performance, good value in there as well. I hear great things from everyone that drives one. It's already becoming a classic in sort of front of our eyes, I suppose that's the way of putting it.
Having been in it myself, the GTR is a stunning performance car. I don't think people really appreciate how good it is. When you get in this car, this would be in your top three for sure. They've got a lot of heritage in producing these high-end performance cars. This is one of the best for sure, and I've been in quite a few.
I drive that car, which is a Nissan R32 GTR. These cars, you know, really quick, the engine's really strong, the four-wheel drive system's great, it's quite comfy. Yeah, I'd say it's a really good car.
And tell me, have you had any experience with a R35 GTR?
A little bit, yeah. A little bit. This car is around £80,000. For £80,000, you can get, 570 horsepower, 0-60 in 2-point-something seconds. That'll go around the Nürburgring at a certain lap time, 7 minutes, 30-something.
Out of 10, what would you score the R35 as a complete package?
10.
So the day is going very well so far. I've babysat, I've golfed, I've spoken to some people about the GTR, and now I have something on the boot of this car that I'm going to use for something awesome. That's right, I've got a bike on the back of the GTR, so what do you say? We go do this and get muddy. During my day with the awesome R35 Nissan GTR, I did a lot of cool things. I took Luca to the park, I went golfing, and I even had my mountain bike strapped to the back. So I guess it goes to prove that yes, the R35 Nissan GTR is a car that you can most certainly live with. We hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to check out our previous Living With videos here and make sure you... say it.
Subscribe.
Subscribe. Good job. High five.